My name is Kayla Kumar, and I'm running for Santa Cruz City Council in the upcoming November election.
Many Santa Cruz residents have been affected by the pandemic, with concerns around childcare, unemployment, and more. As a member of the City Council, what will you bring to the COVID-19 response and reopening plans?
Thank you for that question. It is on the top of my mind, and I think that's probably the thing I want to touch on most, is that this is a core focus of mine as a candidate. I've been talking to a ton of folks in this community about how the crisis is specifically impacting them. And like you said, there's a bunch of different needs. One that's really coming through to me that I will be willing to go to great lengths to meet as a council member is keeping people housed, keeping tenants housed, keeping mortgage holders away from foreclosure, and then doing what we can also for commercial renters and our small local businesses. There's policy levers at our disposal. I want to commend the City Council for instituting an eviction moratorium. I think that that moratorium needs to be extended for as long as necessary, as there's still instability in our community. And where I come in is perhaps helping to understand what is instability, when is it done, quote unquote. And for me, that's making sure that even the lowest income levels are stable, not just folks who are at the higher income levels, although we're all struggling. We need to make sure everyone is stable before we start moving forward and away from some of these stabilizing efforts. So that's one thing, is keeping people housed. There's also a lot of work to be done on making sure that we're advocating for state and federal funding, and making sure that those funds, when they do come, if the federal government ever decides to try on leadership for a change, and those funds do come, we need to make sure that we have city apparatus that are pumping those funds and that capital to the places of highest need, again, being as stabilizing as possible. And then, of course, information. I think information is so crucial right now. And folks, I'm hearing a lot of folks who can't access information because they don't have internet. I'm hearing folks that can't access information because they don't have a device. I'm hearing folks that are struggling to understand the information because perhaps English isn't their strongest language. There's a lot that I think the city can be doing to really around information of what's going on too. And the city is doing what it can. I just think that there needs to be more focus on that, for especially as things develop, right? You know, we're at a new phase of this, it seems. And so how are we articulating that to the people?
Amid the current racial justice movement at the national and local level, what response would you like to see the council take?
Yeah, so when I hear about racial justice in this moment, what I think about is the Black Lives Matter movement, first and foremost. So I'm gonna interpret it that way. I think there's a lot of other really important endeavors too, but I'm just gonna focus on this one because I think that's the moment that we're in. And I would like to see the City Council following in Black liberation leadership. They've called us to begin the conversation at the budget of mass policing. And they've done that because we need to recalibrate and right size the way we create community safety in ways that don't produce the kind of nonchalant murder of Black people, the disappearing of people of color, the devastation and the byproduct, the harm that occurs from the way, the status quo, the way that we're currently doing things. And so for me, I am a leader because I listen to the people, right? And I listen in this case to Black liberation leadership, which is calling us to identify how our fund, what activities are these funds funding? Which ones do you think belong to police? For me, I'm totally fine starting the conversation of, let's have police address actual crimes, things that are designated as crimes. We can start the conversation there. Here locally, that after a report that was released on SCPD in 2018 by the City of Santa Cruz, 15.5% of 911 calls were designated as crimes. So when I say start the conversation there, that we have data to start at this 15.5%. The rest of it, I believe that there are systems of cares or community-based approaches to meeting these needs that are a better use of our funds. Even our local police department say we cannot solve homelessness. We are not social scientists. It's listening really to every stakeholder in this community by recalibrating funds from one way of doing things to this new better way of doing things that's focused on meeting people's needs, the root level. The number one calls that came into 911 that went to SCPD, 20% of calls, welfare checks. Now, I mean, these situations, we need to go case by case, but how many of those really needed someone with a weapon to go to that scene? That's what, you know, could a social worker do that? Could a de-escalation specialist do that? These are the questions that I'm asking because I'm hearing the community ask, right? And so for me, I think if a mental health care crisis is happening, if someone's experiencing homelessness, if there's substance misuse, causing some kind of situation in our community, I simply want people that are trained in those issues to be the ones that meet that situation. And we can talk also about, you know, the models that exist here in this country with CAHOOTS, which is a mobile crisis response approach where people are deployed to scenes that need to be de-escalated or there's some kind of remedy that's needed. And these are teams that are multifaceted. They have healthcare workers, they have homeless outreach specialists, they have de-escalation, conflict resolution. And so there's plenty of things that we can look to. And of course, my background, I worked at a place called Barrios Unidos, and I work with young people of color. Now I'm on the Juvenile Justice and Delinquency Prevention Commission of Santa Cruz County. And so I come from a place of someone, I've worked inside prisons, I've worked inside the juvenile hall, probation centers. I work in these communities of care that are non-police responses that create safety. I know it's real. It's not just possible, it's happening. It's just that the city needs to make a decision of where the resources go, you know, and who are we wanting to invest in? What kind of solutions are we wanting to see? What risks are we willing to take if we continue to do the same? That's not a roll of the dice I'm willing to co-sign, and I strongly believe there's a large number of people in this community that feel the same way from talking with them.
What is one more thing you want voters to know about your platform or goals for Santa Cruz County?
One thing. Voters of Santa Cruz, I've got your back. I've got your back. I will fight for you. I will never stop working for the vision that I'm hearing articulated by our community for this new, better normal, for actual affordable housing, for this transformation in public safety, for a COVID-19 recovery that centers the well-being and is equitable. And for bold environmental justice that's taking seriously science and also the moment that we're in around that. And I'm a fighter. And I do that because I believe in our community. I love our community. I've been amongst you fighting on these issues already. And I'm the one I will step up and make sure that we have a voice on that dais. And I will bring this passion and I will remain rooted in you and what your vision is. You honestly, like, I don't know how people do anything without the people, without knowing what the people are up to, what they want. That's how I roll. Everything I've accomplished is in relationship and learning with others. And that's what I'm setting out to do. So I just want folks to know that there is an option for them. If that's the kind of world, if that's the kind of city council member you want on the dais, I'm here, you know, and I got your back.